Hello everyone. Today we're going to talk about malaria. It's been few months, there was no malaria cases. I will not say completely, but it was very few. And now suddenly there is a spike. It's because of the sudden raining and water collection here and there. So basically the malaria infection has increased. And it is not just few mild malaria cases. We are getting actually a lot of severe malaria. Lots of malaria who required injection. And it could be dangerous. Recently, there was one patient also died because of the malaria. So that's why we decided to make this message to reach people. Well, malaria is a kind of parasite. It gets through mosquito, which bites you, and through their salivary gland they get inside your blood. Now sometime when you have malaria and you go check, it might show there's no malaria parasite at all, because sometime it goes in your liver first and there they multiply and then they come out in your blood. So when you go to a clinic and check your malaria, even though your symptoms are there, but it shows there is no malaria. So sometimes if even it shows negative and you still have symptom, you might need to check it again. Now what are the symptoms of malaria? The general symptoms in Africa, which is falciparum malaria, which is different from India. India is a vivax, but nowadays it doesn't matter. Nowadays we finding the cases of mix, both falciparum and vivax malaria. What are they? They are different kind of parasite and the treatment also different for them. Now when you get malaria, you get shivering, severe headache, feeling cold, high grade fever, muscles and joint pain, severe tiring. It may associated with nausea, vomiting, sometimes diarrhea and abdominal pain. Now there is no proper symptoms like 1, 2, 3 and it is malaria. There is nothing like that. So it could be just a severe headache and it could be malaria. So you should take precaution. Should not take it lightly. If you get a fever, if you're getting a headache or any 1, 2, 3 symptoms, you must come to a clinic and get it checked. I advise you, whenever you want to get checked, go to a proper hospital instead of going to a small peripheral clinic, where if there's no malaria also, sometimes they write malaria positive, and unnecessary taking anti-malaria medicine can cause resistance. Now some patients, they prefer to have injection anyway. Even if it is not severe, they usually request the doctor. They would like to go for injection instead of taking tablets. Why you should not be taking injection just like that? It doesn't apply only for anti-malarial. It also applies for antibiotics. If you keep taking injection for small malaria, small infections, soon those antibiotic and anti-malarial become resistant to your body. So later on, whenever you get a severe infection or severe malaria, then those antibiotic might not work and you might need a very high dose of antibiotic or something very strong anti-malarial to kill that kind of infection. So always take tablet whenever necessary, and if the doctor thinks that you require injection, then only go for injection. Malaria has gone very high nowadays. So be careful. If you get any symptom of malaria, do not take it lightly and always consult your family doctor. Thank you for listening. We'll be coming soon with another informative message to you. Take care.